PCI links and lanes form the foundation of modern high-speed interconnects. Understanding these concepts is crucial for designing reliable, high-performance systems as data rates push into the hundreds of gigabits per second and beyond. At its core, a PCIe lane is a PCI system's basic data transfer structure. It consists of four wires forming two differential pairs, one for transmitting data and one for receiving. This allows for simultaneous bidirectional communication, a key feature of PCI Express. A PCIe link connects two devices comprising one or more lanes. Links are described using an X followed by a number, indicating the lane count. For example, an X1 or by1 link has a single lane, while a by16 link utilizes 16 lanes. One of PCI Express's strengths is its scalability. Each PCIe generation defines a specific bandwidth per lane, and adding lanes to a link scales this capacity linearly. This scalability allows PCI Express to serve various applications, from low bandwidth peripherals to high performance graphics cards and NVMe SSDs. An important characteristic of PCIe links is their symmetric nature. The number of lanes is always the same in both directions, ensuring efficient bidirectional communication. However, while the physical connection is symmetric, the data flow can be asymmetric depending on the application's requirements. The lane negotiation process is a feature of PCIe that allows devices to automatically agree on the number of lanes to use. During system initialization, each device advertises its lane capabilities. The system then determines the maximum number of lanes both devices support and establishes the link accordingly. For example, if a by16 capable graphics card is inserted into a motherboard slot that only supports by8, the link will negotiate down to by8. This flexibility ensures compatibility across various configurations while maximizing available bandwidth. The physical layer of PCI Express has evolved significantly over the generations, with Gen 5 and Gen 6 pushing the boundaries of what's possible over copper traces. These latest generations introduce new signaling techniques and requirements to maintain data integrity at extremely high speeds. Gen 5 operates at 32 gigatransfers per second using NRZ, non-return to zero signaling. In NRZ, two voltage levels represent binary data. The specification defines a normal differential peak-to-peak voltage of 900 millivolts for Gen 5. Timing is critical, with a unit interval, the time allocated for each bit, of just 31.25 picoseconds. Gen 5 marks a significant shift, adopting PAM4, or pulse amplitude modulation 4-level signaling, and pushing the data rate to 64 gigatransfers per second. PAM4 uses four voltage levels to encode 2 bits per symbol, allowing Gen 6 to double the data rate without doubling the fundamental frequency. This helps mitigate some signal integrity issues, but introduces new challenges in signal detection and noise sensitivity. Both Gen 5 and Gen 6 rely heavily on advanced equalization techniques to maintain signal integrity over PCB traces and connectors. These techniques include transmitter de-emphasis or pre-shoot, receiver equalization, and decision feedback equalization. The transmitter applies pre-emphasis or de-emphasis to compensate for expected channel losses, boosting the signal's high-frequency components. On the receiving end, equalization circuits further correct for channel distortions, attempting to reconstruct the original signal. These equalization techniques are crucial. Without them, the signal at the receiver would be severely degraded with a nearly closed eye diagram. Proper equalization can recover a clean open eye even from a highly distorted input. As PCIe speeds have increased, maintaining signal integrity has become increasingly challenging. This is where simulation plays a crucial role. Simulation tools have become indispensable in addressing the complex signal integrity issues in high-speed PCI Express designs. Early in the design process, we used simplified models of the PCI Express link to explore different options. This approach is particularly valuable for addressing several key signal integrity challenges. Attenuation is a major concern. As signals lose strength rapidly along PCB traces, especially at high frequencies. Early simulations allow designers to model this attenuation and explore different PCB materials and stack-ups to minimize its impact. Crosstalk becomes a significant issue in dense multi-lane designs, where signals can interfere with each other. Engineers can evaluate various routing strategies and spacing options through these initial simulations to minimize crosstalk before committing to a specific layout. Impedance control is crucial for minimizing reflections, and early simulations guide the selection of trace widths and PCB stackups to achieve target impedances. Beyond addressing these challenges, early simulations offer several advantages. They enable quick exploration of different topologies, allowing engineers to rapidly evaluate various design options without needing detailed PCB layouts. This stage also guides component selection, as designers can simulate different parts to make informed decisions about which will meet performance requirements. The results from these initial simulations drive the creation of PCB design rules, informing parameters such as maximum trace lengths or layer stackup requirements. They also allow for early verification of substrate performance, ensuring it can support the required signaling speeds. Once we have a PCB layout, we can perform more detailed simulations using models extracted from the design. This approach provides a much more accurate performance prediction and helps address specific signal integrity issues that may arise in the physical implementation. One key challenge at this stage is dealing with reflections. Impedance mismatches along the signal path can significantly distort the signal. By simulating the routed board, we can identify these mismatches and make targeted improvements to the layout. Jitter becomes a critical concern at high speeds, as various sources of timing uncertainty accumulate, making it difficult to recover the signal reliably. Simulating the actual PCB design helps quantify different jitter components and ensure the design meets timing budgets. Power integrity also plays a crucial role in overall signal integrity. Fluctuations in power supply voltage can impact signal quality. Our simulations at this stage can include power distribution network analysis to ensure clean power delivery. Simulating the routed board offers several key advantages. It enables layout optimization, allowing designers to identify problematic areas and make targeted improvements. Verifying the design before ordering physical prototypes leads to significant time and cost savings. One of the most powerful aspects of simulating the actual PCB design is the ability to investigate signals that might be difficult or impossible to measure with physical test equipment, such as the equalized output of a receiver. This insight is invaluable for understanding the behavior of complex high-speed systems. Finally, these detailed simulations allow virtual compliance testing based on the PCIe specification. This capability helps catch potential issues early in the design process, long before physical prototyping begins. Both early stage simulations and detailed simulations of the routed boards are crucial for successful PCI Express designs, especially as we move to Gen 5 and Gen 6 speeds, where the margins for error are increasingly slim. By leveraging these simulation techniques, engineers can address signal integrity challenges effectively and efficiently. Thank you for watching. I hope you found this overview of PCI Express links and lanes informative. Until next time, have a fantastic week.